We got up early and been drinking wine all morning.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Top Heavy, and welcome to another episode of The Dana Show. Now, today's episode is slightly different from the rest. We're not in Pasadena. We're going up north to San Francisco, California, where I spent 5 days for my birthday, and I figured I'd shoot some and share it with you. Hold on to your hats, buckle your seatbelts, because it's time to go to the Bay. So on the first day we got in, we had plans to see Alcatraz. We had purchased tickets prior online, and we just went to the will call window at Alcatraz Landing and picked up our tickets. The ferries leave every 30 minutes, so you can just show up and buy your tickets if you'd like to. They're a little expensive. They're about $38 for an adult, but they do have packages for families. It's worth it. If anything, this should be the one site that you go do. Here's a little bit about Alcatraz. It was opened in 1934, and some of the notable convicts that spent time at Alcatraz: Al Capone, Machine Gun Kelly, Bumpy Johnson, Alvin Creepy Carpus. Alcatraz was an active prison up until 1964, when it shut its doors permanently.
Welcome to the Rock.
So on day two, we headed back down to the waterfront to Fisherman's Wharf and Pier 39. This is also close to where you would pick up the Alcatraz boat. This area is pretty touristy. It's well known and everybody goes down there. It's still a lot of fun and I highly recommend it. Make sure you check out Musée Mécanique. It's an old school crazy arcade that has games from like the 80s to these really classic games that aren't even really games, and it doesn't cost anything to go in. But just keep in mind that, again, some of these games are older, so if you lose a quarter, if it is a quarter, don't go running around looking for someone to get your money back. Just kind of move on to the next one. Exploring Fisherman's Wharf and Pier 39, we decided to take the trolley back up the hill to our hotel. $7 one way. It's a little expensive, but we figured it would be worth it. It's San Francisco. You gotta ride the trolley at least once. And a lot of people had the same idea, and we ended up waiting about an hour. But it does look like that if you go on a weekday and catch it somewhere along the route, there's usually not a whole lot of people on, and you can just pick a seat or hang off the side if you want. So day three, we had a day trip planned up to Sonoma County and Napa County to do some wine tasting at a couple of vineyards up there. It was a pre-planned trip that we had paid for and set up prior. We went with a large tour group. We went to the Mayo Family Vineyard. We went to Kiwong's Vineyard up in Napa, and then finished off at Klein Vineyards in Sonoma. We tasted a whole bunch of wines, every kind you could think of. By the end, everybody was having a lot of fun. I don't think they were taking in too much information though.
The skins get left on for just about 2 to maybe 5 hours afterwards. So with that minimal contact, they just get that faint pink coloring to them. So technically, if you wanted, you could make a white wine from a red grape. It's just you could never make a red wine from a green grape, yeah. For us, our winemaker would tell you French oak gives these really subtle kind of toasty and vanilla characteristics to your wine, where American oak is definitely known for being a bit more robust. Butcher block flavors with American oak.
So the San Francisco Chinatown is the oldest Chinatown in North America and also the largest enclave of Chinese outside of Asia. There's a great bakery slash dim sum place called Good Mong Kok. It's takeout where you just kind of go in, you can order some dumplings, pork rolls, take it to go, you find a park, which we did, and then you sit there and you eat it, and it's a great way to explore the town, So on our last day before we headed to the airport, we had a few hours to kill. So we decided to take a lift down to the Golden Gate Bridge Welcome Center. There's fantastic views of the Golden Gate Bridge, as well as an information stand, a little cafe, and sort of a hub for lots of people going across the bridge to check out the bridge and going into the Presidio, which is what we did. That's where there's a stop for a bus called the Presidigo. So we took the Presidigo bus through the Presidio. We took it all the way to the Palace of Fine Arts, which is this gigantic structure with large columns and a large dome on the water, which is featured in the movie The Rock, starring Nicolas Cage and Sean Connery. So the Palace of Fine Arts was one of 10 palaces that were at the heart of the 1915 Panama Pacific Exposition. They all had different themes and held different exhibits showing off those themes.
Golden Gate Bridge.
That's pretty awesome.
Waiting for the bus at the Golden Gate Welcome Center. Golden Gate Bridge Welcome Center. You can see in the background, waiting for the bus. We'll be right back.
All right, well, thank you very much for watching this video about San Francisco with your boy Top Heavy. I hope it gave you some insight into the city, gave you some ideas on what to do, what not to do if you're visiting. I really appreciate you getting to this point. So if you're still here with me, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and give your boy some love in the comments section. It's always appreciated.